Students, welcome back. Let's continue with this finite automata. So I said the finite automata can be represented in the graphical, tabular and mathematical. So the graphical is nothing but a transition diagram, tabular is a transition table, mathematical is a transition function. Okay, so these will be included in the finite automata. So before entering into the subject or in the we discussed about the different languages, so get a clear idea what is this transition diagram, transition table and the transition function. So in this video I want to explain you what is a transition diagram and the transition table. So with the help of a it's an example, I'll explain the diagram and the table. So first let's see the transition diagram. So this diagram, you also call it as a graph. It is a directed graph. Directed means it should be pointing to some state. Okay, a graph that is pointing to some state, you call it as a directed graph. So it is a directed graph associated with the vertices of the graph corresponds to the state of a finite automata. So let's take a finite automata. So here you are having three states. What are the three states? Q0, Q1, Q2. So these are all the three states that are present. And the starting state is the Q0 is the initial state and Q2 is the final state. So whenever the final state is there, you have to represent it with the two circles. So this represents the final state. This is the indication of the final state, or you call it as an accepting state. So Q0 is the initial state and Q2 is the final state. Whatever the states that are present in between the start and the final, initial and the final, those states you call it as an intermediate state. And here there are two inputs we are taken, 0, 1. So 0 is the one input and 1 is another input. Okay, so initial state, final state, intermediate state, and this should be represented with a directed graph holding their inputs. Now let's see the transition table. A transition table here, it is basically a tabular representation. Table itself, we know that we have to represent it in the form of a rows and the columns, right? It's a tabular representation of the transition function that takes two arguments, that is a state and a symbol. We are taking a state and a symbol. State means either initial state, intermediate state, for final states. And the symbols are nothing but the input symbols. Here in this previous example, the 0 and 1 are the symbols. And the return value is nothing but the next value. That is a transition function, you know that. Delta is equal to, you know, Q into sigma, you will get the Q. Okay, initial state, some state, not the initial state, symbol, you will get the next state. So that you have to know. Now let's see the transition table. The transition table consisting of the rows corresponds to the states. The rows are represented with the states. Okay. So the rows are represented with the states and the columns are represented with the input symbols. Input symbols, that is 0 or 1 or whatever, A, B, alphabets. So set of strings, set of symbols, that is the alphabet. So rows represents the states and columns represents the input symbols. And entire corresponds to the entries. So whatever the entries that are present, these entries represents the next state. Remember that whenever you are writing the table, the rows represents the states, column represents the input symbols, and the entries in that state should be the next state. The start state is marked with an arrow. Okay. So start state is always marked with, suppose this is a start state, you have to mark it with arrow. And acceptance state, the final state, should be marked with star. Remember that. These are the points that you have to remember while you're implementing the table. Okay. So let me show you how to draw the table. Let me take this transition diagram. By seeing the diagram, I have to draw the table. So Q0, Q1. These are the two states. So Q0 is the initial state and here I have taken only two states and Q1 is the final state. So the final state always represented with two circles. Okay. And the Q0 here, in the rows you need to write the states Q0 and Q1. And in the columns you have to write the input symbol. 0 and 1 are the input symbol. And the entry should be the next state. So now see, Q0 to 0, Q naught to 0, what is the next state? If Q naught to the 0, it goes to the next state. What is the next state? Q naught itself. So write Q naught here. Next, Q naught on 1. Q naught on 1, it goes to which state? It goes to Q1 state. So write Q1 in the entry. Now coming to the Q1. So Q1 on 0 goes to Q1 only, right? And Q1 on 1 goes to Q1 only. Okay? So this is how you have to write the transition table by seeing the transition diagram. Now let me explain you the transition function. A transition function here, the mapping functions or the transition function is denoted by delta. Remember that. The mapping function or transition functions are denoted by delta. Here the two parameters are passed to the transition function. One is the current state and the input symbol. So this is the current state and this is the input symbol. You will get the next state, right? The transition function is always returns a state which can be called as a next state. So this is the formula. A delta is equal to the current state, comma, the current input symbol is equal to, you will get the next state, that is Q, it's a current state, into sigma, that is the input symbol, which yields to the next state in the Q. Let me take the example. Suppose delta Q naught comma A, this is the Q naught is the current state and A is the input symbol on that state, it going to the Q1, it's pointing to the next state Q1. In same way, Q naught 1, it's pointing to the Q1. So, whatever the previous diagram I had taken. So, this is about these transition diagram, transition table and transition function. Remember that. Thank you.